okay, so we're going to go about building a meditation pyramid that is fashioned after the Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt. And ours is going to be straight like that, but it will be a skeletal version made out of copper tubing. There's also the angle is important. The Giza pyramid, the bottom, the baselines are about, they're a little bit longer than the sides. You don't have a what would they call it, equilateral triangle where all the sides are the same. The bottoms are a little longer, which makes it sort of grounded in the ground more. That makes sense, doesn't it? And then if you could compare them to Nubian pyramids, which are the sharper angle, taller pyramids. And I did some experimenting with chakras and holding out rubber bands and making various shapes and sizes and comparing how they felt to my body. And the Giza, I really believe, because it's very close to equal, is the heart chakra, whereas the Nubian is more like the throat chakra. And there's all sorts of pyramids, including the Washington Monument is a very slow, very tall version of a pyramid shape. And so the first thing we need to do is go to a hardware store and pick out some copper pipes. And I went with 5-foot pipes that were approximately a half inch in diameter. They had some that were 3/4 inch in diameter and half inch in diameter, I mean full inch in diameter. And I've used the full inch diameter pipes, and I don't think there was a significant difference made by using those, so I went with the 5-foot pipes. So the next thing we need is copper electrical wire to make the base. So I found that also at the hardware store. The next step, when I had a key ring already, which is what my solution was for the holding the ends at the top together. But I wasn't sure it was going to work, so this was a new experiment for me. Oh, when I got home, I had been so long since I had meditated under a copper pyramid that I wanted to put it together. So I used some scotch tape and scotch taped the top together and held it out and just sort of guessed where the legs would go. And I couldn't believe the difference. It was incredible already. It was just a hint of the pyramid with copper is enough for the body to latch onto and work energetically. So that was fun. I took a break and just meditated under the pyramid, but just as using the scotch tape. Then it was time to find out if this key ring thing was going to work. So I had to measure and decide exactly how much space I need. This was an important decision to make. I needed to be able to bend the key ring to get into the holes that I drilled. I needed the holes to be so much so, given the diameter of the tubes, to be able to fit on the key ring and rotate outward, get on the key ring and rotate outward and not hit each other and destroy or bend the key ring unnecessarily. I think you know what I mean. So I marked all the pipes and chose the bit that I thought was appropriate for the width of the key ring, and then went about drilling the holes to make the to fit the key ring on. So I got the first key ring on, and that was going well. And I got the second key ring. I got the key ring on the first copper tube, and that all went well. And it was time to add the second one, and that went pretty well. And by the time I got to the third and the fourth one, it was quite a dance between needle-nose pliers, copper tubes, and keyringing myself. But I managed to manipulate it and not distort or break or unnecessarily bend the keyring and get everything aligned on the... those are pretty big keys, those copper tubes. So everything worked. I was surprised. I was so amazed that it worked as well as it did. And it looked great. And it rotated out perfectly. Seems very strong. I haven't felt as if the steel or whatever else the keyring is made of has compromised the energy of the pyramid. The copper hits the copper. It still makes its continuous move upward. It aligns all the four copper tubes perfectly at the top without... the problem with scotch tape or string or any other else solution that I've found is that one will slip. Even with string or twine, one will slip aside. I can't maintain those four on equally balanced at the top. And so the key ring really worked well to do that. So the next thing I needed to do was to split the wire. These electrical wires come in pairs. You look at any appliance that you buy, and it's basically the same thing, copper wire in pairs running positive and negative. I actually use speaker wire, but still, again, there's two wires. So I had to pull those apart because I only want a single wire at the bottom in each case, holding the bases together. So once I had pulled those apart, I used the I found what bit I felt was the right size again, and I marked the pipes and drilled the appropriate holes, strung the first wire in, tied a knot, tried to cut off the excess. I didn't want the knot to undo, so I had a little bit of excess, and I just tucked that up inside the pipe, and then I had to use the needle nose pliers to, once again, to pull out the copper wire around the corner and get all that situated. And I also needed to use a back end of a spoon anything like that will work to push the excess wire up inside the tube. Another thing I was concerned about once I started with all these wires and getting them set inside the tubing was that I was going to tangle the wires and somehow loop them around in a way that was going to give me a pretzel rather than a pyramid. So I had to periodically take the pyramid and unfold it to make sure that I wasn't getting them tangled while I was doing all the work. That was an important thing. I didn't want to have to go out and buy more copper wire. So that all worked out. And as you can see what a corner looks like when it's finished, and the top of the pyramid, it all worked out very well. You can add some incense or crystals, and the pyramid's great. It's doing all that I wanted it to do. You do have to be careful that your posts stay aligned. The copper wiring can appear like a snake to your friends at home, but there is no mistake about its energy. Oliver is proof of that, for he knows exactly where to hang out.